here's your water bottle, babe, huh?
Thank you.
And here's my water bottle. Because it's hot. Mm. It's fan life hot. When we especially closed the door half for you guys. Mm. There's some construction going on where we are. Mm. It seems there's construction everywhere these days. So, excuse for that. But it is what it is in van life. You don't always can choose your surroundings. Well, actually you can. Hop in, babe, we're going.
Woohoo!
Well, your new friends from the Netherlands used to have a house left into the mouth. Got an old RV, got Penelope, she's a 1983. Pictures and patterns of design. Penelope loves Rob until the end of time. Well, RVlicious, if you like a vibe, please subscribe. Please subscribe.
First question is by Rose.
Order the merch shirt.
Yep.
It's still on the way, probably. Mm-hmm. Let us know when you get it.
Mm. What is your next project with Penelope? Good question.
Plenty of projects.
Mm. Yep, indeed. Our next project will be the floor. We're gonna have to pick out a new vinyl. It fits.
Yeah. The floor. Next question will be from Arden Timmer, who also ordered a merch shirt.
Mm-hmm. Let's see. Yeah, two questions actually. Oh, three questions in total. Mm. How is your work doing? And did you get more clients? it could be more
than definitely more
than
yeah.
we would like, but it's trickling in. Did you ever get an accident or almost accident on the road? Yes, we what I can remember, we almost bumped into a tree and a truck.
Yeah, communication is key here, because I asked Petra when driving backwards, I said, isn't there a pole? Mm. And she said no, but there was a tree, and then I hit the tree. And
well, it was dark.
So it was dark, but I did not say, do you see any obstacles, like poles and trees and everything. Mm. So she just looked for the pole and not for a tree.
No.
And another time I can remember, I asked Petra, isn't there any car approaching from the right? Mm-hmm. And she said, nope. And then I pulled up and then there was a big truck approaching from the right.
Mm.
So I had to ask, isn't there anything approaching from the right?
Mm.
Because Petra just looked for cars, she didn't see any, only a truck. So sometimes that kind of stuff could bring you into little trouble. The most accidents will come from other people hitting you when you're parked on a camper spot. That happened to me. I hit, in the first year, I hit somebody when I was trying to park.
Mm-hmm.
I hit another camper. Hit, kissed, bumper kissed.
Yeah.
And when we were parked in Vianen, the camper spot, mixed parking, a bus camper was trying to park in behind us.
Mm-hmm.
And didn't go properly the first time.
Yeah.
They tried the third time and fourth time and fifth time, and then they hit us.
Mm.
So I've still got a little dent in the bumper to show for that.
Mm-hmm.
But other people parking next to you, that's the more dangerous sometimes, more danger on the parking lots than on the roads.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
It seems.
Yeah.
Although if you get into an accident on the road, it's probably a worse outcome. But but there's more danger we noticed on camper spots.
The next question is from looking good.
A good looking buddy from overseas.
Yes. Hello, Dutch buddies. My question is, when can we expect to see your CD or digital album? Ooh, that's a tough one. I think we got about 4 summers now, so maybe 2 or 3 more.
It takes a while to find a spot to practice at. We hope that the songs will go faster. We can produce them faster if we go into Europe and find more open clear spots with privacy to make the songs or to record the songs.
Yes.
And yeah, that's a thingy. So at some point we just said, well, let's just upload it. It's not perfect yet, but that's van life. Sometimes you have to make the tough choices.
Yeah.
But it is coming.
Jay Jongste? First question, Pet, what is your favorite book?
Well, Pet, my favorite book is the book that I wrote myself, and you can order it on avalanche.com/shop. It's my personal favorite. I can recommend it because I wrote it, of course.
Second question, Pet, me, yes, what is your favorite film? Well, there are a lot of films I like, but the one that made a big impression was Avatar. Pat and I went to see it in the cinema in 3D, and it was very impressive, very beautiful movie. And the third question, do we have a favorite song as a couple?
We do, and we just recorded it. We just watched back a couple of videos, playlist, our music videos, our own song, of course, which we just produced, The Last Van on Earth.
Next question is from Leven in a Camper. I hear that the client is visiting you. How is it going with work? Have you got a regular assignment? Work is going too slowly, I think. We would like to have more assignments.
Yeah, it's not coming in on a monthly basis. So
we
cannot say, hey, at the end of the month, we're going to get paid this much, which is... Yeah, I mean, there's a lot of work going on around us, there's a dog barking and everything.
Yep.
That's also part of what we like. You're getting the real experience here, not going to edit that out. But it's not coming in monthly, and that's a bit of a shame, because it is helpful, because sometimes for the months that we don't have anything coming in, we have to use what we earn to pay up with the bills that we're behind on. So we're always racing. It's always the race with the budget. So sometimes nothing comes in, we cannot pay certain bills, which then stack up, and then as soon as something comes in, we pay the due bills, which leaves paid bills but nothing extra to go forward into the month.
Yeah.
So we're always walking behind ourselves in that sense, still, which is a shame.
Yes.
But is what it is still.
Next question is from S.M. van der Steenhoven. If you don't make money for months, how are you living? Well, we have Patreon, we get donations, and we sell stuff online. Check it out, arbalicious.com.
/shop. Yeah, we have AdSense again. We're already making $4 bucks AdSense at the moment.
Yes.
Because we have thousands subscribers. AdSense was turned on again, luckily. We do have things coming in. We have made a budget video not so long ago. If you want to know the exact details,
check
the budget recent budget video out. We also have a playlist with budget videos.
Yes.
Since when we started, so you can see how our costs have evolved.
Yes.
And but the other thing is, you don't need much in van life. Because if you don't have much coming in, you don't travel as much, and that keeps the cost low.
Yep.
If you don't spend any fuel, you don't have any fuel costs.
Yep.
And in a house, it's different because you have rent regardless if you have income or not.
Mm-hmm.
And if we had been in a house with this little work, then we would have a huge debt already.
Mm.
And now we have zero debt. Mm-hmm. So it's all a trade-off.
Yes.
Yeah. So,
indeed.
Great question. Mm-hmm. Next question.
Arlo Vey. From Arlo Vey. How are you surviving the heat? Well, we open all possible doors and windows. And we use the little USB fans.
Yeah, it's simple as that. We open all the windows up,
yep.
And keep if there's a breeze, it's perfect.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
We did notice compared to other years when we had much more woodwork in the van.
Mm.
Now it's much cooler.
It's cooler.
Really the difference is enormous.
Yep.
If you see how much wood people sometimes carpent into their vans.
Mm.
That's like building a Swedish sauna.
Yes,
and
it is.
We have so much wood removed that it's really a noticeable difference for the heat.
And of course it helps to find places near the coast because there's a lot of wind there.
Wind.
Breeze.
Yeah. Yep. We don't know how it will be in the winter, but we'll find out soon enough.
Yes.
But in summer, having a light van, it's brilliant. It's amazing.
Yep, it is. Thanks for your question. Next question from Mobile Wonen.
Also living in a van himself.
Yes.
In Belgium.
Yep. Mm-hmm. What would you do differently if we would restart this lifestyle? Yes. Well, we would probably get one bigger size penny. So we can get a steady bed, because that's a thingy.
Yeah, even though Herman helped us, Herman Gea helped us as an experiment, build a bed in the side, so Betty could sleep, I could work.
Mm.
In the practice, it turned out it did not work. We're still moving stuff around. We still got stuff on the bed now,
yes.
And if I want to work, my base wants to sleep, we have to move everything off.
Hmm.
And then I'm still surrounded by stuff. We cannot just go to, even though we minimalized what we could, and we still can do more, but it just doesn't fit in this van.
Everything.
It's for two persons full time. It's a great van, but it's a one size too small.
Yeah.
It would be so much more easy if you just could go in the bed or go. If I'm working on the laptop, I don't want to go on a huge tangent here, but working on the laptop and we want to eat, I have to put everything away.
Yep.
And then after dinner, I have to put everything back. And we're constantly moving stuff around.
Yes.
And that's just not.
Well, it does keep you active, but yeah.
Yeah, it does keep you active, but it's not practical. A lot of times I'm working until at night, and then it's like 1, 2, 3 a.m., and then you have to build the bed. We have to move all the stuff from the bed onto the chairs and then climb into the bed, and then you just make a lot of noise for the neighbors that are parked next to you.
Yes.
And it would be much more practical if I could just leave the laptop on the table and hop in the bed. And that's not possible inside Penelope yet.
Not yet.
And in hindsight, the bed sideways was a nice experiment, but it's just too small.
Yeah.
So we would have to make a bed in the length.
Yeah.
And we could still do that.
Yes.
bed in the length.
Yes, we can open the back door.
And we can open the back doors. For now it's a bit hard to reach the back doors and the windows there. So we all have to crawl halfway over the bed to open a window, close a window, open a curtain, close a curtain. In hindsight, a bed in the length would be the way to go. And with open from the from the front to the back to be a path.
Yes.
And then maybe we should work with a bench. Or two couches, couch benches on every side in the length.
Yes.
To have at least, Peter could sleep on one bench, and I could still sort of work on the other one.
Yeah.
Yeah, we would have to figure it out, but we're not doing that now because the budget is not existing for any more changes at the moment.
Mm-hmm.
So we're kind of stuck with what we got for the moment, but the good news is, it was built in half a day. It can be changed in half a day as soon as we got our financials figured out. Which might be a long while from now. But you never know.
It can change like that.
Can change in a jiffy?
In a
jiffy?
In a heartbeat.
In an HP.
Yes. Next question is by Maurice Engels. He based his question on the question of mobiel wonen. He asks, what would you do exactly the same if you had to start over? So what would we do the same if we started over? Oh, that's a tough one. by Penny, of course. yes, buy a Penny, at least a Mercedes-Benz. That's definitely something we would do exactly the same. Do you have more?
Yeah, I think what we would do the same is explore the Netherlands, explore all the camper spots within your budget. If you're planning, I mean, you're doing this full time, so we explored the Netherlands the first year to see which areas would be worth going back to. So which areas are good for electricity, which areas are good for privacy, which areas are good for stores. Here is nice for showering, here is nice for... Make a list for yourself. What we did was we made a tour of the Netherlands and we mapped, charted for us personally the best spots. And I think we would do that again. And in addition to that, if one of us has a bad vibe, be willing to drive off. I think we would still do that, and probably more soon than we did in the first year. The first year we tended to stay in places that we were not happy with. We tended to pay sometimes 5 days in a row for a spot, or 3 days, or even 2 days. And then if something happens, you stay because you pay. And in a free spot, you just can go anywhere because you didn't pay for it. It's free, that you don't feel obliged to stay longer than in a spot that you have paid for.
Yes.
So,
great
question.
Yes. Next part of that question. What is, by Maurice Engels, what is the biggest thing about van life you learned? For me, I think the freedom to go where you want, whenever you want, stand where you want, drive off whenever you want. Yeah, that would be my biggest thing I learned.
Yes, I agree, because in a house sometimes you have something like a situation with neighbors. You hear that so many times, neighbor wars. And with van life, If you don't like your neighbor, you remove yourself from the neighbor. You have wheels. Your house, in normal sticks and bricks, doesn't have wheels.
Mm-hmm.
So in the sticks and bricks, you tend to deal with a lot of situations longer, or people longer, than you would in van life. In van life, you just hang out with great people and you just avoid less great people. And much easier than you would if those people were living next to you. You would have to find a way to make it livable.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
That is one of the huge things, the freedom
mm-hmm.
to leave.
Yeah.
And freedom to go and to stay.
Yeah, exactly.
Freedom.
Yeah.
Freedom!
And in addition to that, what is the biggest thing you learned about people in general? Well, for me, that people do, even though they might not want to, but do judge you by the, in this case, van you drive. Because we have a so-called cheapish van, you get judged on that. Which is ridiculous, of course, but that's one of the things I think I learned about people.
Yeah, I mean, we all do it.
Yep.
We all do it, but it is, you see it more often in van life. Sometimes somebody in a expensive rig parks next to you to feel better about themselves.
Hmm.
And other times they avoid you because you have an old camper van.
Yep.
So it's much more space for us.
Yes. So that's an advantage. There's a lot of questions coming from Jager JF01. First question. Does the small budget result in some stress? No, because we don't have many expenses.
We're out of the rat race, mm-hmm. the rat race from the working and having to work a lot to mm-hmm. pay for a house that you never are living in.
Yeah.
We don't have that anymore, we don't have the traffic jams anymore. We do have another race, and that is the race between budget and breakdown, between budget and saving. We cannot save at the moment, we're very vulnerable to breakdowns, we cannot upgrade the van. To our wishes yet, and sometimes that does give you stress.
How do you deal with it?
It is the only thing you cannot really control. So we cannot control when we get clients, we cannot control mm-hmm. when we get new patrons, we cannot control when somebody buys a merch shirt from the web store.
No.
We can only promote the products that we make, and
yes.
Luckily people are awesome and a lot of people do buy things.
Does it sometimes make you want to make new choices for an income?
I don't know what the question means exactly, but if it would mean, would we go back into a steady job? That would mean the end of the channel.
Yes.
We have seen people who went back to living in one spot.
Mm.
They stopped making YouTube videos.
Yep.
They stopped making YouTube videos. And the content plummeted almost to the non-existence.
Yep.
And if we want to keep making YouTube videos, which we are doing, then we need to be mobile. Mm. We need to travel. The choices we make have to fit within our current van life. A job we have will have to fit with our van lifestyle.
Yeah.
And it can be digital nomad jobs, it can be an income not through a job but through support mm-hmm. by products we sell.
Exactly.
And that's not just fairy tales, because we see a lot of channels who make a living that way. People buy their stuff from the web shop. People donate to them
mm-hmm.
because they want them to make more videos and keep making more videos. Because you have to understand, not everybody in life has financial worries. Some people are doing financially very well and are very generous at the same time. So sometimes people who are very generous want to help you along, because you create something they like, and if they can help you by being generous to you, I mean, that's awesome, right? We get generous donations and people say, please We want them to stay anonymous. So it's not even about ego boosting for them. Mm. They donate to you and they say, please keep it anonymous. We don't want to be named. We don't want to be named with our real names. So use a fake name for them. So people are just generous. And if you make a video that somebody who's very generous wants to appreciate, then that's all you need. You don't need a job. That you need a job is old-fashioned thinking that fits maybe with an old-fashioned lifestyle.
Yeah, exactly.
But being vlogging about our van life, making a real-life documentary about it, which we do now for 2 years and 7 months, being the first to do it in the Netherlands, that is kind of our job.
Yeah.
And the interesting thing for people who watch us is, since we have a low budget, are we going to make it or not? It's the race, like I said, between our budget and breakdowns. What will happen first? Will our budgets go up or will there be a breakdown first? That's our main vulnerability at the moment. And that is worrisome, but we have something like, regardless what happens, it will be learnful for somebody out there who is watching us.
Mm. Yes.
So.
Another question by Jaeger JF01. I really love the songs you pick. What is your history in music, Patrick?
Well, thank you. Yes, usually I pick the songs and Petra approves my choices, yes or no. So sometimes I pick a song and Petra says no, and then I pick another song. My history in music is when I was like 16, 17 years old, I had my own radio show. So I had a live radio show. You could call it a live podcast, but it was on the radio, so not from home. I had a real radio, local radio station. I went there and had a radio show, so I was always interested in music. And later I hung around as a student. A lot of people who were around me were musicians, very creative musicians, and some even turned professional. I always loved that they were able to play instruments, and that inspired me to play an instrument too. Not as good, because you really need a lot of practice to be really good at it. But fortunately, I'm at least good enough to compose a YouTube song for our channel with Petra sometimes. That's good enough for me. We don't need to go perform in clubs and as much, maybe at a Vanlife festival someday. Petra?
Yes, why not?
Did I answer the question? Yeah, I was in a band. When I was living in Amsterdam, I was in a band and we rehearsed a couple of times, but eventually I was the only one motivated enough to rehearse every week, and the other ones didn't want to rehearse as much. So we fell apart before we even really clicked as a band or started as a band. We already fell apart again. So I was in a band, but yeah. I also was not.
Next question by Jaeger JF01. How is the vegan lifestyle going for you?
How's it going?
Yes, how is the vegan lifestyle going? Perfectly. We haven't had meat since a long time already. Maybe a year.
And I can't even remember.
One and a half.
We don't miss it, we don't crave it.
No, not at all.
We love being vegans. It's easy, you don't need a fridge. People say, where's your fridge? We say, we're vegans. We need a fridge.
Yeah.
That humming thing that costs power and electricity and makes noise and breaks down. We don't need it.
No. Next questions, a lot of questions, are by John. He said, we asked for it, and here we go.
Now we're in for it.
First question, why do you upload only in 720p? Well, because we don't have much storage, so we keep it simple. And 720p is quality enough, I think.
Yeah, if you look at the file sizes of bigger quality video, are so insane sometimes. It doesn't fit on my laptop. I only have limited storage on my second-hand laptop. It was not a new laptop I had. I have now. It's very limited. It's a good laptop, but it's limited in storage, which means we're limited in what we can offer as video quality goes. I've looked at 1080p videos and 4K videos. It doesn't really do it for me. Most videos you watch on YouTube are still in 720p. It's the main one. Will we upgrade at some point? Sure, but we gotta upgrade our laptop and storage first. Making videos is a lot of gigabytes in storage.
Yeah.
Making just a video for you guys like this one will be probably around 8 to 10 gigabytes of file size.
Yeah.
So. That's maximum we can do at the moment.
Yes. Next question. Do you listen to podcasts?
Yes, we do.
Yeah,
we listen sometimes. To Stefan Molyneux, Joe Rogan, and that's about it.
Yeah. next question. What about starting your own weekly Vanlife related podcast? Yeah.
We're already doing much behind the scenes. We're making now the magazine, making the photo books, making the videos. Podcasts would require us to have more budget to get some podcasting gear, and require us to have more access to electricity. And if we would want to invite guests, we would have to go on paid campsites where guests are comfortable enough to use the bathroom. we would have to invest in podcasting gear. We could do it on the fly, on the low budget fly, but you would have to get at least a basic setup. We might do it in the future. So never say never, but with our current budget we're just limited in those energy eating stuff.
You mentioned you are an interviewer.
And professional interviewer, yes.
Yes.
It is true.
And needed a camera with long battery life. Now you have one for almost a year and we haven't seen a single interview. When can we expect some long interviews / podcasts?
Yeah, great question. Fair question too.
Yes.
We have not met people that meet our minimal requirements. There have been candidates that I thought, hey, these people are interesting, or this person is interesting.
Yes.
But then they either didn't want to be on camera, or their English is poor. And I'd only want to interview people who want to be on camera. I don't want to just show a van. If somebody says, I don't want to be on camera, I don't want to waste my time on them. That's a rule, a professional rule that comes from the magazines that I worked at. If somebody wants to be interviewed, they have to be enthusiastic about it, have to be willing to talk and willing to be in view.
To be interviewed.
Because then it gets real. People don't want to be interviewed. I don't interview them. A lot of people that I want to interview are traveling around at the moment. And we're usually traveling around the Netherlands, and we travel too little at the moment to meet the awesome people, vanlifers out there, or just interesting people. It's all about who you meet on the road, basically. Who do you meet? And if you meet somebody, is that person willing to be interviewed? Is that person able to speak English? And a lot of times, people are not. We met some awesome people who we could have interviewed, no problem. But either they didn't want to be filmed, they didn't want to be on camera. And I don't really have the budget to say, well, I'm going to pick somebody, I'm going to meet up with them, going to drive there, wherever they are. That's in the future. When we have more budget, we can do those things. So it's who do we meet?
Yep.
And usually people say, hey, you can film my van, but not me. And being a professional, I don't want to do that. I want people who are willing to talk, are willing to show the van, and are willing to talk in English, because we have an English audience. I don't want to do the extra effort of subtitling everything, because things do get lost in translation, and it's a lot of extra work. So it has to be a match.
Mm-hmm.
I haven't found any candidates yet meeting my high quality professional demands.
Yeah, so it's purely practical and not because
we don't want to.
Yes.
Believe it or not, an interview takes a lot of time. When I was a professional interviewer, an interview usually lasts about 2 hours and up to 4 hours if you want to do it properly. And that's just for an interview that you write about. So you can maybe imagine that a real van life interview takes a bit longer even than that. Because you also have to film shots, and you have to prepare, and you have to... So it takes about a day to do it good. You can do it on the fly, of course, but if you want to do it a bit professionally, it takes more time, more preparation.
Have you considered moving to Germany, Poland, Hungary on paper for cheaper Rotex, internet, etc.? No. We have not.
No, and the reason is that we don't know those countries. We would have to be in another country first long enough to know if that would be a match for us to consider emigrating to there or registering there.
And
that would be a huge step into countries like Hungary or what was it?
Poland
or Bulgaria. You don't speak those languages, you don't know the people, you don't know the areas, which makes it pretty hard to consider that Germany is an option. Many people from the Netherlands, they emigrate to Germany.
Yes.
It is an option for sure, but then you would have to... I think living in a van would come. It would be a bureaucratic mess. And we got things sorted at the moment, so there's no need to change anything.
Any progress on your movement to Portugal? No, still working on it.
Yeah, we cannot afford the fuel to get. We don't have the fuel to travel that distance yet, but we would love to if we could.
Yeah. Since you mentioned in the budget videos a while ago that you were able to pay off debt.
Yep, three buddies.
Yep. If you continued with the same income and setting that money aside, I expected a basic solar setup by now. Any progress on that?
Yeah, with that money we were falling short every month because we had to pay off the debt. And now we're falling a bit less short, but still falling short. So it's not like we have it left laying around. We spend it on an extra tank of fuel. Or an extra haul of groceries. Mm-hmm. And then it's already spent.
Yep, exactly. What happened with the plans of starting a Dutch channel? It's on ice.
That's never going to happen. The Dutch country and the audience of that tiny country interested in van life, specifically, is just too small to grow. And keeping it international. Because with full timing, we want to share it with as many people as possible.
Yeah.
And by doing it in Dutch, we limit ourselves to the world. So we want to be able that everybody, if you're in China and you speak English, or if you're in Mexico and you speak English, or wherever you are, if you speak English, you can understand us.
Mm-hmm.
And by making a Dutch channel, it would be double the work. And it's if other Dutch fan life channels want to interview us in Dutch, we'll do that. But it's just too much work. We have to make choices.
Yep.
Maintaining one YouTube channel is taking everything we got at the moment.
Next question. Are you happy with your current camera setup for your videos and Petra for photography? Any wishes? Well, I am satisfied with my camera, so yeah, it does what it's supposed to do, and yeah, that's the most important part.
Yeah, I'm content too. I'm very happy with the new camera. It took a long while for me to find it and select it. And it was a good choice, and
yes.
I have no regrets. It's better than expected. The audio is good.
Yeah.
The stabilization is good. The battery life is good. And I have no wishes. It's a perfect camera. It can be dropped. It can be wet. It's perfect. It's if we would have to buy another camera, I'd buy the same one.
Yeah, it's pretty all round. So. And how much data do you consume on a weekly basis when you are not in the Netherlands? Well, we only got 10 gigabytes to spend. So we try to keep up with it.
Yeah, in the Netherlands we spend about 5 gigabytes per day.
At least, yes.
And when we are abroad, we try to spend 5 gigabytes per week.
Hmm.
Usually 1 gigabyte per day.
Yeah. Yeah. If you had a choice, would you like to work for 2 months full time in the off season, like winter, and have enough money and freedom for the rest of the year, or work a couple of hours weekly? Hmm. I think a couple of hours weekly.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yeah, because if it's every week, then it's something you can rely on.
It's steady. Yeah.
And if it's only for one season,
it's,
then it's a very... then you have like three other seasons of insecurity.
Mm. Yes,
and
exactly.
If you do a temporary job that requires you to be in one spot for all season, that just doesn't fit with our mobile lifestyle either.
No.
We know of people who do that. We talk to people who do that. They go work on a farm, or they go work
big
in a pick fruits or drive pickup trucks or whatever. But that's usually people who have not the skills that we have. We have skills that make us much more money when we have clients. And it would be a shame to put our skills not to do the best job we can do. So it would be not make sense if digital nomads go pluck apples, because we have options to do otherwise, and usually people who do that work don't have other options. That's the reality of it. If we go 3 months plucking apples, then for 3 months you will have videos like, well, today plucked some apples.
Also, yeah.
And next week you'll have a video the week after that. Well, we plucked some more apples.
Exactly.
And the week after that is how to pluck apples. And then it is how many apples you can pluck. And it will be very boring content.
Yes.
And
content-wise also, yes.
It's, yeah.
Yeah, exactly.
We have to consider our audience, our viewers. We have to keep it interesting for the viewers. And,
Next question.
We need something not only for a season. We need something for continuation.
Regularly, yes.
So not, regularly. Even though we do take clients, one day fly clients, but that's because it's in our field of expertise.
Yes.
So we don't have to learn how to do that, how to work how to design a logo or how to design a website. We know how, we already mastered those skills.
Yeah. Have you heard from your family? And what happened with the family fortune? Can we expect a new RV? Well, I have not heard anything from my family since we uploaded It Never Happened.
Yes, very interesting.
Yeah, go check that one out if you want. So, no, I have not heard anything.
Yeah, it would have been the happiest day if for those who don't know, my parents inherited €150,000 from my grandfather, who was a banker and an investor.
Mm-hmm.
And they used that money to manipulate me in Petra instead of saying, here it is, buy a new camper van, enjoy yourselves, go out there, we're fully supporting you.
Yeah.
They made the decision to manipulate instead of support. And that's their decision. They're adults. They made a bad decision. We talked about that the other day. And is it? I could say, well, they just don't support van life, but I would be lying. When I was 17, I told my parents, "Hey, I like music. I'm gonna start my own radio show." And my parents, what they did was, they had a card game. During at that time, or I had a radio show in the weekend, and exactly around when I had evening, Saturday evening, 7 o'clock till 8 o'clock, and my parents had a card game going on at 7 o'clock till later. But what they did was they put on the radio, but they never tuned in to my live radio show. They tuned in to another channel.
Mm.
So even then, they were not listening.
Supporting.
They were not supporting. They were not. They had a card game with family members or friends, and they did not say, "Hey, look, listen, Patrick's on the radio live."
Ideal situation to.
They were ashamed of it, so they turned to another channel, and they listened to that. And the result was, when I came home, I asked them, "What do you think of the show?" "Well, we'd listen to another station, radio station." So they never said, "Well, very great how you, we loved especially that topic or that show, how you handled this and that."
Mm-hmm.
So even back then, they were not supportive of what I was doing.
Mm.
And I had to think about that this morning, because now the radio show is a YouTube channel, and they're still not on board with that. And it's sad, because it's sad they could follow along so they could understand better what I was doing, but it was never about van that they don't support van life specifically. They just don't support whatever I do in life, and they rather want me to do what they want for me in life, which is very selfish of them.
So we cannot expect a new RV. No,
that's the thing, because as parents, I've said this before, because you know you did a great job as a parent if your adult child chooses voluntarily to hang around with you and spend time with you and talk with you and finds it important what you have to say, because there's a bond, and the bond you create during the raising of the children. You have a bond. You work towards the whole education of the whole childhood. You work towards that when they grow up, they'll still want to be around you. And my parents didn't do that. They never bonded with me. I have no recollection of bonding with my parents. Or going to them with something that they were enthusiastic and supportive about. I have no memories of that.
No.
And so the way that they do it now is they pay for your time. So in case of my brother, they're not bonded with my brother either, but they pay for him to visit them. So they give him money and he comes around. If they would stop giving money, he would stop coming around. It's almost a business deal.
Mm.
And it's unwritten, and we're not like that.
No.
If you, if they pay us money to hang out with them, we don't fall for that. We only want to hang out with nice people that we like and have something to share with.
Yeah.
And then you guys and our family on the road, Ham and Achea.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
But it's not my parents. And even though we would love them to chip in for a new RV, they did dangle it in front of our faces. Last time we were there, they said, we got now, we got this inheritance, we can buy you a new RV or camper van, no problem. But we're not going to do that, because first you have to jump through some hoops for us.
Mm.
And that tells you everything, I think. I don't want to... And the thing is, considering their age, they're both nearing their 70s, it's not never going to happen. It was not my choice how they divided that fortune.
Mm-hmm.
But even before they had the fortune, we asked sometimes for free, can we have an address at your guys' place? Mm-hmm. It doesn't cost you a dime.
No.
They also were against it. And like I said, in my childhood, they were already against things. My brother wanted to open his own restaurant. They were against that. He'd never opened a restaurant. They are more about crushing dreams than supporting dreams. Because if they crush the dream, then you are at their level. Because they never had a dream that they fulfilled. And it's just painful to see that your kids are. Well, a lot of parents say, hey, I love my kids to do better than I did.
Yes, exactly.
But my parents not. They want you to pull you back into the bucket, like they say with the crabs.
Mm-hmm.
If one crab tries to crawl out of the bucket, the other crabs pull you back in. That's basically my family history in a bucket shell.
Yes.
In the crab bucket. It's very sad, but I have accepted that they chose money over me. And my parents did that, my brother did that, and they're both adults. Like I said, dividing an inheritance between two kids is not rocket science. It's just like I'm going to give the same amount to both of the kids at the same time. And that's it. And be happy with it. And show us what you do with it.
Yeah.
It's not everything else that they invented for us to do. My parents always said, oh, if we won the lottery, we would help you guys. Now they won the lottery in a sort of sense.
Hmm.
Have they helped us? No, they did not. They offered us money to quit van life and not to continue van life. So they're not on board. And how can you not be on board with something amazing as what we're doing with the van life and everything? Because they were never on board with anything I did. They are driven by fear—the fear of what can go wrong—and that has held them captive. That fear always.
Mm.
And we always say, but that fear is what the price that you pay for a lot of adventure.
Mm.
And of course, things can go wrong, but they can go wrong anywhere, not specifically in van life. Mm. But it's. We rather be doing what we're doing, what we love to do when things go wrong, than not doing what we love to do out of fear.
Mm.
And that's different, defines us from our families.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And how Petra's family do.
Yeah.
They could be on board, could be sharing, supporting, liking, commenting.
Yeah, exactly.
And that would have given us such an amazing boost. But these 1,000 subscribers, you guys, Patreon, I built them up ourselves.
Exactly.
With the help of everybody who's watching, we build it up. And not with help from our friends, not with help from our families. This is explaining the slow growth.
Mm.
But that's why we say you guys are a real family. If you're watching this video, you're part of the family.
Yes, the brothers and sisters we never count.
Yes, so thank you for that.
Thank you. Can you guys commit to a standard upload schedule, since most of your content isn't time-bounded?
We can, but we won't.
Yes, exactly. It's too restricting, I think. Some people have the
Some people need that pressure to keep making videos. We just love making videos, so we're making videos whenever they're ready, we upload them.
Yeah.
And limiting yourself to a schedule, we have seen that people,
many people,
then they not deliver on that. I'm used to delivering on deadlines, so we could do that.
Mm-hmm.
But why? If there's nothing to report, we're not making a video.
Yeah.
And if there's much to report, we're making more videos.
Yes.
And not just on a schedule. And by not doing it on a schedule, we hope that we reach more people eventually.
Mm-hmm.
We're watching it on different times, different time zones, different countries.
Yes.
And by limiting it, we would limit ourselves to the Dutch prime times or the UK prime times.
Mm-hmm.
Or the USA prime times.
Yeah.
And we're just doing it whenever we have access to Wi-Fi, when we have access to power, when we have good 4G internet.
Mm. Very important.
Mm-hmm. And that cannot be put into a schedule.
No, exactly.
The only thing that we schedule is our What's Up With That magazine, that we do one time a month.
Mm-hmm.
And it has all the scheduling we do. That's the only thing that's on a deadline.
So otherwise, it would probably get too boring, and it would be you feel the need to upload because it is scheduled, and not because you have something to say.
Yeah, people sometimes say every Monday, every Wednesday, every Friday, and Tuesday we're gonna do this, and Thursday we're gonna do that.
Yes.
Then they don't.
Then you upload to upload, and not because you have something to report.
Yes. So it's too limiting for us.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
When we fill an episode, we fill it to the max.
Exactly.
And we don't need to do different things on different days.
No, exactly.
So in our case, it's too limiting. We love our freedom.
Mm-hmm.
When we have, usually we know it. I say, well, now I think we got enough for a video, and we make a video, and we don't look at the times.
No.
Do we miss on subscribers that way? I don't know, maybe not. But if you just click on the bell notification, you just get a notification, and you can watch it on your own schedule.
Yes, exactly.
I mean, if you only want to watch our videos on a Wednesday, you can just save all the videos that we make
yes.
not on a Wednesday until it's Wednesday, and then you watch them all then. Or you can watch them.
Mm-hmm.
You can schedule them for yourself. That's the beauty of it.
I mean,
we don't need to schedule it for you.
No, exactly. It's a bit weird.
Yeah. It's impossible to pick one time that works worldwide for everyone.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
You can base yourself off favorite vloggers, travel vloggers. When do they upload? I could mimic that, but and surf on that wave a little bit, but too restrictive.
Yeah, exactly. And the last question by John. There it is, the last one.
Yes.
What happened with the famous pet ranting videos?
Well, I still make them. The rants, paid well. I still do them.
Yes, that is true.
And usually they're hours long, and they fill up all my hard drive. But I don't always upload them anymore.
Maybe it's because we don't eat meat anymore.
Yeah, that does help, yes. We try to avoid situations that cause long rants. Usually the long rant is triggered by an event that we experience, or like we paid for a camper spot, and then something happens and you stay because you paid, and then you rant about it.
Yes.
So we wouldn't make another castle video rant, because we're not going to get into those situations anymore. We become better at seeing the red flags and avoiding them.
Yes.
We came there for the castle tour, we didn't get it, we should have turned around right away. I should have put the van in reverse and drove backwards out of there, screeching tires and all.
Yep.
And we could have vlogged about it too then, and it wouldn't have been a rant. just have been, well, we came for a costume, didn't get one, what's up with that, buddies? And on our way again, merry way. We rented about a Dutch camper club. We cancelled our membership. That's how we solved rents about that. We cancelled the membership. If we would stay members, we would still be renting about how they deleted all our reviews. We just stopped writing reviews. We stopped being a member of clubs like that. We don't want to associate the Avalicious brand with
snobbish.
Snobbish or dubious organization. We keep it more happy.
Yes.
That's the thing. You can say, well, let's go to war. Or you can say, let's leave and keep traveling. Mm-hmm. Keep the wheels
rolling
into mm-hmm. greener pastures and sunnier beaches.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's it.
That is what we can control. We can control where we steer towards and where we steer away from.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm sure there will be more rents in the future. But some rents just became less because we made better decisions.
It's been a long
you have
2 hours.
If we make 2 hours, it'll just be 10-minute video. So that was a long one.
Uh-huh. Indeed. Yes. Thank you for your questions. It was fun answering them.
Yes, we scratched a whole lot of surfaces there.
Mm. Yes, thank you.
Now the hard job of editing it all together. Luckily there's not an upload schedule. If you have liked this video and still watching, then you must really be a fan of Avalicious. Mm. So you might want to consider getting a merch shirt, of course, or becoming one of our passengers on Patreon, like
Zulfa Wolf, Leven and then Kemper, Bizarre. Rick Conley. Around the world in as long as it takes. Donna and Ralph. And Rose.